Welcome to ARC 2. I am a radiological scientific officer, and this is our survival complex. One of the first questions I was asked by everyone is, how do you get fallout out of the air? In the case of a nuclear war, and that is what this survival complex is built for. That is one of the very most important things to do, and that is what I am going to explain in this video. The big tanks that are on top of our shelter are the air filters. First, let us review why the air needs to be filtered. When a nuclear weapon is detonated near the ground, a mushroom cloud appears and goes up into the stratosphere. This cloud carries with it dust from the ground and nuclear particles which have attached themselves to dust or debris. The wind blows the dust downwind. It can be a relatively narrow tail, but it can extend hundreds of miles downwind. If you are a half mile either side of the tail, you may be perfectly safe. On the other hand, there may be lapping fallout from multiple detonations, and the wind may spread it a wide area. Fallout is usually just very fine dust, and we can test for it by just using a regular dinner plate. Just take a clean plate, put it outside, come back and check it a few hours later, a number of hours later. Wipe your fingers across it, and if you don't find any dust, feel any dust, then it's probably okay. What we have here is an air intake tank with a down-facing pipe that is several feet above the ground. The fallout falls out of the air onto the ground, which is why we call it fallout, and it doesn't fall into the pipe. We will now go look inside the tank. This design alone keeps most of the fallout from entering the shelter. There are a number of peepholes all around the tank so that we can see any other tank and any other direction from inside. Because using this design, very little fallout remains suspended in the air. Many people worry about buying expensive filters for their shelters, but just hanging a damp bed sheet at the bottom where the air comes into the shelter is enough to take out any remaining fallout particles.
So this is the air intake shaft. It's also an emergency exit from the shelter. We have these steel ladders that go down into the shelter. We use the shaft sometimes for other things, like to bring up exhaust or something like that. We have a pipe here that we've extended up this shaft. To go down in the shelter, simply step around here. Ladder, well, down we go.
Thank you for watching, and please remember that ARC 2 is not just about your survival. It is about service to humanity and preparing to reconstruct society.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the